Active London. Coming up next, we have Laura Foll, who is the co-fund manager for Lowland Investment Company. She'll be discussing the trust's recent performance, highlighting some of the key drivers of that performance, dividend trends here in the UK, as well as some of the main concerns impacting businesses right now.
On a six-month basis to the end of June, Lowland performed well. It outperformed its benchmark, which is the FTSE All Share, and its peer group, which is the AIC UK Equity Income Sector. If I look at the drivers for that, at the sector level, the industrials portion of the portfolio was the most material contributor to that outperformance. And industrials are a big weighting within Lowland. They make up approximately 30% of the overall portfolio. There were some stock specifics in there, the likes of Somero Enterprises, which makes kit for the US, predominantly the US construction industry, the likes of Senior, which is an aerospace component supplier, and the likes of IMI, which is a very specialist engineering company, were the three key drivers at the stock level. But just taking a step back and what drove the industrial sector more broadly, it was that these companies took out really significant costs during the pandemic last year. And what you're now seeing is the sales begin to recover. So you're seeing the likes of Senior, the likes of IMI say, actually, you know what, organic growth might be a bit better than we were expecting this year. And that comes at a time when costs have been looked at really hard during the last 12 months. So what you're starting to see is an earnings recovery that was faster than the market had anticipated, you know, 6 months, a year ago. And you're starting to see that those higher earnings be reflected in share prices. So there were individual end market drivers of each of those industrial companies, but taking a step back, it's really the recovery in organic growth at a time when costs have really been pinned down. There were also a few more stock-specific drivers of Lowland's outperformance, and they would include K3 Capital, which is a corporate broking company. It's a company we've held since IPO in Lowland, one that we've been following for a long time. They did two acquisitions last year. It was funded by equity that we participated in for this trust, and those two acquisitions are so far going well and have been well integrated, so that's really encouraging to see. Another driver of outperformance was Halfords, which I think we're all aware of as a household name. And it's a very common sense reason for why it did well. You know, during the pandemic, lots of people wanted to avoid public transport and cycling, which Halfords is a market leader of bike selling here in the UK. You know, Halfords really benefited from that strong demand for bikes during the pandemic. I think what we've seen over the last 6 months has been really quite encouraging on dividends. We've seen the majority of companies that suspended dividends during the peak of the pandemic return to paying. And to give you a few recent examples, you know, Halfords, which I mentioned in the previous question, has very recently returned to paying a dividend, having suspended it. We've also seen companies that benefit from consumer spending on their houses. So the likes of carpet distributor Headlam, the likes of window frame company Epwin, again, they've very recently returned to paying a dividend. So we've seen a very encouraging trend of companies return to paying. But I think what I would say is that, and for completely understandable reasons, the dividend payout ratios remain quite conservative. So what you're seeing company boards doing is saying, you know, yes, we'll return to paying a dividend, but, you know, we're still unclear about the trajectory for this domestic economic recovery. So we will return to paying, but it will be a relatively modest dividend with a modest payout ratio. So I think what we'll see happen from here is those companies will carry on paying dividends, but as the earnings recovery carries on, you'll see companies feel more comfortable with paying not only a higher dividend, but also a higher dividend as a portion of their earnings. So in my view, there will be further dividend growth to come from these levels. Now, that's not to say that we'll necessarily get back to 2019 levels in the foreseeable future, because there have been companies, most notably the likes of Royal Dutch Shell and BP, that have permanently rebased their dividends. So I'm not saying we'll get back to 2019 levels in the forecastable time horizon, but I do think we'll continue to see dividend recovery from here. So a big part of Lowland's investment process is based on meeting companies. So what James and I, who manage the portfolio together, do, you know, day in, day out, is meet company management teams. And that's what we really enjoy spending time doing. What we're hearing from them at the moment very much chimes with what we're seeing on the headline inflation numbers. So we're seeing headline inflation numbers in the UK and the US pick up. And we are hearing that from companies as well, almost across the board. And they're saying there's inflation in labour, in, you know, raw materials, in machining, in scrap metals. You know, I could go on. There seems to be inflation across a really broad range of areas. And not only inflation, but also just complete supply outages. So to go back to Halfords again, you know, they literally cannot get their hands on bikes fast enough because this demand surge has been unprecedented. Or similarly, if you talk to Vertu Motors, which is one of the motor retailers we hold in the portfolio, you know, they're struggling to get hold of the amount of cars that they want to sell. Or, you know, Studio Retail, again, a retailer we hold, can't get its hands on enough garden furniture. You know, these might sound like niche examples, but they're popping up sort of here, there and everywhere, these supply outages. So we definitely think the inflation pressures are real, and there are also supply outages to deal with as well. So what does that mean? I mean, going back to Lowland investment process, you know, what we're looking for is market leading companies that are really specialist in what they're doing, you know, whether it's a product, whether it's a service, but they are the market leader. You know, it could be a market leader in a very small niche area, but they're the market leader nonetheless. And what these companies traditionally have, you know, if you are the market leader, you tend to be a price setter and with an ability, therefore, to pass on that cost inflation that you're seeing. Maybe with a lag, you know, maybe with a 3-month, 6-month lag, but you have that ability nonetheless. That's not to say we're being complacent about it. It's something we're talking to companies about a lot. But, you know, take a step back. And what we have is a portfolio that we think is of market leading companies that do have the ability to pass this inflation on. But it's something that we're watching very closely.